Praise the Lord. Lord.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Lord, we come to you this morning once more. We gather here to praise your name, to lift your name up on high, dear Lord. Lord, we thank you for bringing us here safely this morning. We thank you for all you have done for us, that you are doing right now, and what you will do for us in the future. Lord God, we thank you for food. We thank you for raiment. We thank you for the shelter. We have so many out there without shelter this morning. But Lord, we ask that you will cover them. Cover them, dear Lord, with your blood. Thank you, Lord, for all that we are going to experience this morning.
Yes.
Your word, Lord, that you will shine the light upon our hearts this morning. And that all darkness will be chased away
yes.
from us, dear Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Bring us, dear Lord, under one accord. And that when we leave here this morning, that we will not leave as we came, but that we will leave with the Holy Spirit indwelling in us. These prayers we ask in Jesus'
name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. I don't hear you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
What a beautiful day it is today.
Amen.
God has blessed us with a beautiful day. Amen. He knew you wanted to stay home all week, so he allowed it to be cold all week. But he made today beautiful, so you have no excuse.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You ought to be in God's house on the Lord's day.
Amen.
What a privilege we have. Just want to welcome you here this morning and to thank God that you are accounted for.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Last night I left my phone at church, and then I came back for it in the night because I said, just in case I miss a call. But thank God I didn't miss any call. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I didn't get any call. So I praise God that you're all here and I can give thanks for you. Is there any first time visitor here this morning? First time in our worship service? Yes, ma'am. Please give us your name.
My name is Mary Dennis.
Praise the Lord, Ms. Dennis. And who invited you?
God.
God invited you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Well, as God's spokesman, I welcome you in the name of Jesus. And I pray that your visit will be worthwhile and that you'll be spiritually enriched as you leave here today. Amen. You will get a welcome packet right now, or you've had it already. Please fill out the visitor's card so that we can be in touch with you. Amen. And I notice Sister Dunkley's sister is here today. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
All the way from Baltimore, from
Queens.
Oh, she lives in Queens. Okay. I think you were far away, that's why you're not coming to church. Oh. Okay. I thought you moved, you know? Okay. Well, we just welcome you again. Glory to God. Let us greet each other now in the bond of love. We are one.
We are one in the bond of love. give him praise. This the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. Yes, the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. The Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh,
I'm gonna
worthy to be praised.
Hallelujah.
Lord, we lift you up. We give you praise.
Yes.
And we bless your holy name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise his name. At this time, I'd just like to give a shout out to God for all the goodness that he's provided not only to myself, but my family.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Lord, for waking me up this morning. In my right mind, Lord.
Yes.
With a roof over my head, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
With clothes on my back, with food on the table. Lord, I give you praise for everything that you do.
Everything.
And all the goodness. And I'm sure there's some shout-outs. There's some praise reports amongst his people. Come on, let's shout it out, people. Testify to the goodness of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, let's praise testify.
The
praise the Lord, brother.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
Him.
Praise
Glory
the Lord.
To God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm so glad.
Yes.
For this day. I'm feeling real good for this day.
Hallelujah.
Seeing the sunshine out here. Mm. Hallelujah. Wake us up this morning.
Yes. Amen.
Dear brother, say
hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Yes.
I'm feeling good.
Amen.
And I'm glad I make it in.
Hallelujah.
Because when we read the scripture,
yes.
The word of God,
yes.
Pointing to us the way out here and what the Lord God has suffered for you and I.
Amen.
Then we'll be ungrateful that we can lift him up. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
This morning,
amen.
Yes,
amen.
Because when I read the scripture here and show us if we obey God,
yes.
And stay with him, all belongs to us.
Amen.
And we are his children.
Hallelujah.
Yes, praise the Lord. The Bible said, even the Psalmist said, we are able to go up and possess the land from Jordan to the sea.
Hallelujah.
And though giants are out there trying to prevent us, with the grace of God, we won't be the enemy.
Hallelujah.
And that's the reason why I love that man so.
Hallelujah.
Because who he said, who I have in my hand, no evil can take them up.
Hallelujah.
And I believe God.
Amen.
The word of God said, let the weak say, I'm strong.
Yes.
And let the poor say, I'm rich.
Yes.
And that's the reason why I love him so, for all things is in his hand.
Yes.
And if we are obedient to our Father, he's going to say, here, children, take charge.
Amen.
Bless you.
Amen.
Pray me up.
Yes. Hallelujah.
For I tell you, I know better.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord. Hallelujah.
New heights I'm gaining every day.
Yes.
Lord, I'm
praying as I onward bound. Lord, plant my feet and higher
ground. Hallelujah.
God, the head of my life. Mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He's so to hear.
Hallelujah.
This morning I am glad to be in God's service one more time.
One more time.
One more
praise
time.
The Lord.
And the reason why I am glad, he didn't have to make me live. Praise God. But he did. He wake me up this morning in my right mind. Praise God. I can see around. I can hear with my two ears. I can walk to the Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Every day of my life, I am blessed. When I wake up in the morning, as I lay my head to rest, I am blessed. Praise the name of Jesus. I must tell you that Steve is back in the hospital. Praise God. It's not anything so serious. Praise God. But he went there and he said that he was having fever and headache. So they admit him again. So I'm asking you all to pray me up,
yes.
And
praise
to
God.
Pray for him.
Hallelujah.
Because God said I should ask what I
yes,
need,
sister.
And it shall be done.
Hallelujah.
Because I have proven God.
Praise
over
the Lord.
And over again. And
amen.
I know that he is real.
Yes.
Nothing is impossible for my God.
Nothing.
All things are possible.
Glory
if
to God.
Only believe.
Yes.
God bless you all this morning. Your prayer might strengthen the Lord. Because I did not know the way I've taken. Rough and tiresome though it may be. I said, Lord, I will go through it.
Hallelujah. God bless you, sister. In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise
the Lord.
Praise
the Lord. Are there any other testimonies? Any other shout outs?
Don't turn back.
Yes.
Don't turn back. For sins we made at start for heaven, don't turn back.
Hallelujah.
Jesus died on Calvary. He paid the price and set us free. So since we make a start for heaven, don't turn back. Lord, I said, don't turn back. Lord, don't turn back. Lord, since we make that start for heaven, don't turn back. Jesus died on Calvary. He paid the price, Lord, and set us free. So since we made a start for heaven,
turn back.
Praise him!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah. Praise God!
Hallelujah.
Glory to God!
Hallelujah!
Amen!
Praise
the Lord! Any other testimony? Any other praise reports? Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Glory. Hallelujah. Glory.
Yes!
Yes!
And the strength that
you
gave.
Amen!
Yes!
Hallelujah! Glory!
Yes!
Amen!
Hallelujah. Amen, sister.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, sister.
Praise the Lord.
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 Amen. My God is real. He is real. Oh, I know He. Praise God, my doubts are settled, and I know He's real. God is real, He's real. Oh, I know He's real. Praise God, my doubts are settled. I know He's real. God is real.
Yes.
He is real. Oh, I know He is real. Praise God. My doubts are settled. And I know, yes, I know. God is real, He is real, oh, I know He is real.
Praise
God, my doubts are settled, and I know, yes, I know, He is real, He is real. He is real. Oh, I know He is real. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
My doors are all settled. I know, yes, I know He is real.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise His name. Hallelujah. All the other shouts. Any other praise reports? Glory to God. Hallelujah. But He is worthy to be praised. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory. Hallelujah.
Praise.
Glory. Jesus. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Praise His holy name. Hallelujah. Are there any other praise reports? Are there any other shout-outs? Any other testimonies? Hallelujah. Praise God. If there are any other testimonies, Mr. Keyshawn, may you proceed forward as we give God some praise, as we worship and honor His holy name. Thank you. Shining, the beast of the dawn, the shining.
early to these praises. Upon the wings of the wind.
Who maketh his angels spirits, his ministers of flaming fire.
Who laid the foundations of the earth, that it should not be removed forever.
Covers it with the deep as with a garden, waters to the bottom of mountains.
At thy rebuke they fled, at the voice of thy thunder they hasted away.
They go up by the mountains, they go down.
Thou hast set a bound that they may not pass over, that they turn not again to cover the earth. They gave drink to every beast of the field, the wild asses quenched their thirst. He watereth the hills from his chambers, The earth is satisfied with the fruit of thy works. And wine that maketh glad the heart of man, and oil to make his face to shine, and bread which strengtheneth man's heart.
The trees of the Lord are full of sap, cedars of Lebanon, which he hath planted.
Where the birds make their nests, as for the stork, the fir trees are her house.
High hills are her refuge for the wild oats, the rocks for the
corn. He appointeth the moon for seasons. The sun knoweth his going down.
Thou makest darkness as it is night, to marry all the beasts of the forest to creep forth.
The young lions roar after their prey and seek their meat from God.
Sunrise, they gather themselves together, and lay them down in their nests.
And altogether, man goeth forth unto his work and to his labor unto the evening. Amen. You may be seated. Praise the Lord for his word. Praise the Lord. As we go to God's throne, please turn with me in your hymnals, number 630, for the friend we have in Jesus. 630.
Mercy, who have no new birth as you do, please remember them today as we go to prayer. Please remember the Christians who are being persecuted all over the world this morning. Those families who are bereft in Iraq and all these countries where Christians have no freedom to worship as you do. Some have been killed just recently. ISIS brought the children of God and have them dig their own grave and shot them to death. Remember them this morning. Pray for the leaders of ISIS and all these people, because even though they have committed atrocities, if they should bow their heads this morning and ask for the mercy of God, He will forgive them of their sins and cleanse them from all unrighteousness. Just the other day, I heard the testimony of one of them. He said he was with a group to bomb this building, and all his fellow soldiers or whatever they call themselves died. But he said as the building went up in smoke, he saw the Son of God. And he said as he saw it, a voice said to him, "When you go home and your daughter greets you, you will know for sure that this was Jesus." And as he went home, his daughter ran to the door. His daughter had been crippled for life. And she ran to the door and met him. And he bowed his head. He gave his heart to the Lord. He was a murderer. But Jesus chose to show himself to him. Nothing is impossible with God this morning. Don't give up on any of your relatives this morning. Don't give up on any of your friends this morning. Because there is a possibility that God will show up. Jesus will show up. Let us go to prayer now. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. Eternal God and our Heavenly Father, we come to you with praise and thanksgiving and adoration. We lift you up because you are holy. Your name is holy. Heaven is your throne and the earth is your footstool. There is nothing made that you did not make. And you are sovereign God over all the earth. Your word says that you will plant your church upon the sure foundation that Jesus Christ is Lord. He's the Son of God, and He's the Messiah, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against her. So today, God, we thank you for this place to which you have brought us this morning, a place where we can come and call you Abba Father. And so, Lord, as the eyes of children look to a father, we look to you today. We come, Lord, in deep humility, knowing, Lord Jesus, that our righteousness compared to your righteousness is nothing. But we are happy today, Lord, that you seek to clothe us in your righteousness and to bring us into right relationship with yourself, so that we are able to come to the throne room and to bid you, Lord Jesus, to be merciful to us.
to be kind to us, to be gracious unto us. And we know, Lord, from your word, that you are merciful and kind and forgiving. So now we ask you to forgive us of all our sins and to cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Take the words we shouldn't have said that we have said. Take the words that we should have said that we did not say. God, in the name of Jesus, remove the things we shouldn't have done that we have done. And Lord Jesus, forgive us for the things we didn't do that we should have done. Lord, we thank you this morning that you are the God who forgives the sin of omission and the sin of commission. And we come believing you and trusting you today that in the name of Jesus, we can stand in liberty because your blood has set us free. We put the president and his cabinet before you this morning. God, we ask you in the name of Jesus that you would touch the hearts of these men. Because we know, Lord Jesus, that you put up kings and you take down kings. So the president is there by your will. And we ask you in the name of Jesus that as you speak to the hearts of kings before, that you will speak to the heart of the President of the United States, that you speak to the members of Congress and the Senate, that you speak to the members of the judiciary, that they will be merciful, that they will temper wrath with mercy this morning, that God, they will reach out to those on the outside. Lord, they are locked up in their chambers and they see everything as perfect. They are isolated from the harms and the danger that are out there on the street. So Lord God, in the name of Jesus, give them awakening this morning. Touch their hearts and make them know that there are those who need mercy. And Lord Jesus, you will have mercy this morning on those who have mercy. So God, in the name of Jesus, give them compassionate hearts to do, Lord God, that which is right, to be merciful and kind. God, we pray this morning for all politicians everywhere, presidents, princes, kings and queens, everywhere, God, prime ministers. Lord, we pray for them this morning. Have mercy upon them and give them wisdom. Lord, we pray this morning for the school children everywhere, for those who lack this morning, those who do not have the wherewithal. Lord, we pray for provision for your children this morning. They are hungry, Lord God. Many hungry children in this world. Their stomachs are protruding because of malnutrition. Their bones, Lord Jesus, seem to be sticking out of their bodies. God, we pray in the name of Jesus that you will have mercy upon them. We pray this morning, God Almighty, for all ministers everywhere, preachers of the gospel. Lord, we pray for them this morning. We pray that you'll give them courage, Lord Jesus. If ever we need courage to speak your word, it's now, Lord God. The world, Lord God, is requiring that we be politically correct, that we do not call sin sin, but that we compromise your word, Lord God. Help us never to compromise, God. Be with us in life and in death, as, Lord, we have covenanted to walk with you and to talk with you and to take your word to the utmost parts of the world this morning. We pray for those who are touched with the diseases of this world, HIV, AIDS, Ebola, chikungunya, all the other diseases, God. Oh God, we pray in the name of Jesus that you'll touch hearts this morning, that you'll heal arthritis this morning, bursitis this morning, that you'll touch those with cancer this morning. God, in the name of Jesus, we pray that you'll be gracious unto those who are in pain this morning. And as they lift their eyes toward you this morning, we pray that they will see Jesus.
and they will call out to him for help this morning. God, we pray this morning for Vivian Jones, for the Proctor family, for Pat Clark, Grace Moore, Evelyn Payne, the Green family, the Malcolm and Esther Plett families, the Williams family, the Wright family, the Lal family, for Hyacinth Williams and family, for the Lindley family, the Ms. Walker and family, for Barbara Reed, oh God, Norma Dunkley, Sydney Coleman, Marie Dennis and family. Pray this morning, God, for Stephen Wright, who is in the hospital this morning. Pray for his wife, Valerie, this morning. Pray for Sam Barkley, Lord God. Pray for him this morning, that you'll touch his heart. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that you will touch these folks whose names we have called out to you this morning. Lord, there's a roll call here this morning. We pray this morning, oh God, Lord Jesus, that you would be gracious unto Gertrude Duncan, that you would bring healing upon her body this morning. Pray for Sheldon Roach, wherever he is this morning, God, that in the name of Jesus, you would touch him from the inside out. Pray for his wife this morning, that you'd be gracious unto their household, that you'll bring healing and restoration, and that you'll make them whole. God, oh, we love you this morning. We know, Lord God, that there is nothing impossible with you this morning. Oh, God, you can calm the waters. Lord Jesus, you can rebuke the floods. Oh, God, this morning, you can part our Red Seas this morning. God, you can rain manna from above where we're hungry this morning for your divine touch. God, in the name of Jesus, as we reach out to the hem of your garment this morning, Lord, as we press through the crowds of our infirmities and our maladies this morning, and we reach forth and we touch you this morning, help us to be able to sing. As we leave this service today, he touched me. Oh, he touched me. God, in the name of Jesus, touch everyone here this morning. Bring healing and restoration. Come in your fullness and your mercy this morning. Come with your still, small voice this morning. Lord, we pray this morning. Your word says that anything that you have not planted shall be uprooted. So whatever is in us that you did not plant this morning, in the name of Jesus this morning, uproot it, Jesus. Remove it, Almighty God. Take it from us this morning, because we want liberty to praise you and to give you glory and to give you the honor and the praise that is due to your name. Lord, we leave all our concerns at your feet. Your word says that we don't even know what to pray for. So we ask you, Lord, as the Holy Spirit takes our prayers today and bear them up to the throne of grace with much groaning, that you will be gracious unto us. Thank you for all you've done for us. Thank you for what you're doing now, Lord Jesus. And thank you for what you're about to do as we say thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Praise his name this morning. Hallelujah. The New Testament reading, the gospel, praise him. From Colossians chapter 3. Please turn with me to the third chapter of Colossians. I will be reading verses 8 down to 17 of Colossians chapter 3. When you have it, please stand. Give God all the honor for his word. Amen. Colossians chapter 3, verses 8 down to 17. Amen. But now ye also put off all things, all these: anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds, and have put on the new man, which is renewed in the knowledge after the image of him that created him, where there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcision nor uncircumcision, barbarian, Scythian, bond nor free, but Christ is all and in all. Put on, therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, bowels of mercy, kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, long-suffering, forbearing one another, and forgiving one another. If any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye. Above all these things, put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness. And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to the which also ye were called in one body, and be ye thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And may God send a blessing to the hearing and the doing of his holy word.
Amen. Good morning, church. Good morning. You open your bulletins. Page 3. If I mark your calendar. Thanksgiving Day service will begin at 10 a.m. Please invite your friends and relatives to come out and give God thanks for Thursday, November 27th. We are now having rehearsals for the Christmas program, and this Saturday coming is at 2:30. This program will be form of a cantata on December 21st at 11 a.m. We see Elder Johnson is over there, Pastor Lloyd, and Mavis Morris. If you want to participate or assist, everything you do will be greatly appreciated. And we turn over. Announcement: sick and shut in. Please continue to pray for Sister Evelyn Green and family, Sister Virtual Duncan and her entire family, and Brother Sheldon Brooke. January announcements. As a reminder, there's no food or drink permitted in the sanctuary. All announcements must be calling or sent to the church office by Wednesday. You can contact Sister Joyce Duncan to donate all the flowers or to place flowers for family, friends, or loved ones. And as a reminder, we ask that you do not leave empty bottles and other containers in the sanctuary. Please take them with you or ask for directions where you can place them. We're asking everyone not to move around the sanctuary during the prayer, the reading of the scripture, and the delivery of the message. Please remain in your seats and be prayerfully attentive. Parents, please supervise your children. We have a birthday today. This is Sister Evelyn Green. And anybody else? Only Sister Brick? Yeah. So Kishan, can we?
Yeah.
continued good health and enjoy the remainder of the day.
Thank you, church family.
The weekly schedule is as such, and Sunday morning's prayer meeting is at 9:30, Sunday school is at 10 a.m. Sunday worship services 11 a.m. and 6 p.m. No 6 p.m. today. Bible study Wednesday 6 p.m. Chancel choir rehearsal on Thursday 5 p.m. Prayer meeting Fridays at 7 p.m. Dance men ministry meeting will be the third Saturday at 2 p.m. and that starts in January. Yes. We want to thank everybody for worshiping with us today. We ask that you come again and bring someone with you. If you're a first time visitor, I will be a friend of the day. And you're looking for a church home, we ask that you consider becoming a part of this warm, nurturing, and edifying ministry. Please fill out and return the visitor's card in your welcome packet and hand it to the usher or place it in the offering plate. Because of global and evangelistic ministry, we welcome everyone.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Just want to ask you one favor. Please do not leave your bulletins in church. Take them home with you. Don't leave them in the Bibles and the hymn books. Take them home with you. Look how beautiful they are. You can almost frame them. Take them home with you and look over the things and the events and the activities of the church and the scriptures and read the scriptures again. And you see how wonderful it is. Amen? Amen. But please take them with you. God bless you.
Amen. This time, let us worship God by returning his tithes and his offerings. The general offering will be first, and then directly following will be the utility offering. Now, amongst those two offerings, do not put your harvest thanksgiving offering with the first two offerings. The harvest thanksgiving offering will be taken last, and the two ushers will come to the front where you will come and drop it in a basket, the harvest thanksgiving offering. And we will have the general offering first, then the utility offering. There it is. Thank you. The offertory selection in your hymnals, number 170. special envelope for Harvest Thanksgiving. This is utility offering.
Give thanks to the Holy One. His friends, because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. Say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. And now, let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what Lord has done for us. Give thanks.
The ushers now please come to the front.
As we sing Bringing in the Sheaves, we're going to ask everyone to bring their harvest envelope and put it in the offering plate. Today you will bring, let me see the hand of those who had a good harvest this week.
Praise the Lord.
Let me see the hand of those who thank God for the harvest they had this year.
Praise the Lord.
So now you're going to give an offering of thanksgiving, which is the first fruit for your harvest. So as we sing Bringing in the Sheaves, please march up and put your offering in the, yes, they're coming up, in the offering place. Amen?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves, we shall come rejoicing, ringing in the sheaves, ringing in the sheaves, ringing in the sheaves, we shall come rejoicing, ringing in the sheaves, ringing in the sheaves, ringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, ringing in the sheaves, ringing in the sheaves, ringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, ringing in the sheaves, ringing in the sheaves, ringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, ringing in the sheaves. Ringing in the sheaves, ringing in the sheaves, we shall come rejoicing, ringing in the sheaves.
Amen.
Amen.
Rejoice even beyond these walls and lift up your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. In
Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Sermon selection in your hymnals. Well, it's in the bulletin, actually. The insert on page 2, Thanks to God, My Redeemer. And we'll all sing from the bulletin. So please stand at this time for the sermon selection. It's in your bulletins on page 2. Thanks to God for my redeemer.
Have thorns. We thank you today, God, for the life you have given unto us. And we praise your name for the eternal hope in your word. As we look to your word now, we ask that that hope will be manifested and that we, Lord Jesus, will be drawn closer to you because of your goodness and your mercy. Use your word, Lord, right now, to quicken our hearts and our minds and our bodies. As we wait upon you and trust you, anoint your word upon us right now, God. This creative word, this quickening word, this word that is alive, we ask you, Lord, that it will give us life as we leave ourselves completely in your care, saying thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Please turn with me in your Bibles to 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. When you're there, please say amen. We'll be reading verses 16 through 18. Very short verses. These are three New Testament commandments. Three New Testament commandments. Verses 16 through 18. Three New Testament commandments. This chapter here from verse 14 down to the end has 14 New Testament commandments. We have three right here that we'll focus on today. Rejoice evermore. Pray
without ceasing. In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. In everything give thanks. In everything. That's not a suggestion. That's a New Testament commandment. In everything, give thanks. One night, the biblical scholar, Matthew Henry, who has written one of the most profound Bible commentaries of all time, he was robbed. When he got home, he was still trembling with fear. And as he regained his calm, he prayed. And this is a prayer he offered, and he wrote it in his journal. Father, I thank you first because I was never robbed before. Second, I thank you because although they took my purse, they did not take my life. Third, I thank you because although they took everything I had, it was not very much. And fourth, I thank you because it was I who was robbed and not I who robbed. One of the greatest marks of spiritual maturity is the ability to give thanks.
Amen.
The ability to give thanks when it is tough. Therefore, the sermon title this morning is Giving Thanks in the Tough Times. You see, anybody can praise God when everything is going well.
Yes.
Next week you'll see people in church who said, I couldn't be here last week because the whole world was coming down on me. And that's the time when they are supposed to be in church. But their troubles kept them from church. We have all sort of excuses. One of the greatest marks that you can bear as a Christian is the ability to give thanks in tough times. This is what Paul meant when he says in 1 Thessalonians 5, 16 through 18, rejoice evermore, pray without ceasing, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Hallelujah. When you read that passage, it should lift you up in praise. Because you'll find the will of God for yourself. A lot of people have been looking for the will of God. Here is the will of God for you, that you give thanks in all things. In all things. I once asked a preacher to preach at a service once, and he came and he read this passage and he says, it could never mean that you give thanks in all things. And I'm sitting behind him and I'm saying, but you just read it. Why did you doubt it? You just read it. You know, sometimes you ask people to preach and you want to get up and stop them. I say, let me finish the sermon. Because they get up and they say the most atrocious things. But God says that we are to give thanks. Rejoice evermore. Pray without ceasing. Give thanks, for this is the will of God concerning us. Hallelujah. G.K. Chesterton, when asked what was the greatest lesson he had ever learned in life, he said, "The greatest lesson I have learned is to take things with gratitude and not to take them for granted." The greatest lesson you can learn is to take things with gratitude and take nothing for granted. You see, once you know you are in the will of God, you can't believe that it is obvious. You can't believe it is voodoo. You can't believe that it is hatred. You can't even give the devil credit for what's going on. You can only say, "I am in the will of God."
Yes.
Thank you, God. Because this could never happen unless you allow it.
Amen.
You see, all the other excuses are for people who are not Christians. It's for all the other people who do not know Jesus Christ as Savior. But when you know Jesus Christ as Savior, when you know you're in the will of God, you say, "Thanks. Because God, you entrusted me with this affliction. I am in your will, and you know I won't let you down." You know how many Christians curse on their deathbed? You know how many Christians you have to tie down when they die? Huh? A lot of Christians, they have no trust in God. And they can't understand that they are in the will of God. Chesterton also wrote, "You say grace before meals." All right. But I say grace before the concert and the opera, and grace before the play and the pantomime, and grace before I open a book, and grace before sketching, and grace before painting, grace before swimming, grace before walking. I say grace before playing, and grace before I dip the pen in the ink. He says grace for everything. When I get a cup of coffee, I bow my head and I say grace. If I take a sip of it before I say grace, I stop. And I say, "Thank you, Lord. I want this to be only good for me. I want this to be only good for me. Thank you, Jesus, for the slice of bread with butter. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you." You see, some of you haven't had really had tough times. You can't recall tough times. You don't know what it is to have tough times. You don't know what it is to buy a penny hip and a brown soap. You don't know what it is to buy a half a pound of flour. You don't know what it is to bake some salt. You don't know what it is to beg a little sugar. What you call hard times, some folks would love to live your life. Tough times. Most of the tough times that we are in now, we created them for ourselves. See, I don't want you to say time is tough when you owe credit card bill. Because you did that to yourself. See, God didn't do that to you. So when you go and you credit up Macy's stuff and Lord and Taylor and all of these people's stuff, and you're struggling with that bill, you did it to yourself. You created that monster. And he sleeps with you. He wakes with you. He goes to work with you. You need to know what tough times are. Throughout scripture, we hear the call to give thanks. Thanksgiving is faith in action. This morning, I heard somebody on TV says, Thanksgiving is about overeating. That's what I heard the guy said on TV. Thanksgiving is about overeating. And I bet he overeats without saying thanks. And that's in total disobedience to scripture. Because the Bible says if you're a glutton, put a knife to your throat. The Bible says if you're a glutton, put a knife to your throat. Do not indulge. The Bible calls it suffating. Suffating. Overeating. Overeating. Overindulgence. So that's not what Thanksgiving is about. Thanksgiving is about giving thanks. Deuteronomy chapter 8 verses 10 and 11 says, when you have eaten and are satisfied. Here's what the verse says. We say, that means you must say grace before meal and grace after meal. Listen to this. Listen to this. Deuteronomy chapter 8 verses 10 and 11. When you have eaten and are satisfied, praise the Lord your God for the good of the land. That's what the Bible said. When you finish eating, before you fall asleep, because you ate so much, praise the Lord for the good of the land he has given you. So here's a prescription. Grace before meal and praise after meal. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise after meal. Grace before meal, praise after meal. Be careful that you do not forget the Lord your God. Be careful that you do not forget the Lord your God. 1 Chronicles chapter 16 verse 8 says, give thanks to the Lord. Call on his name. Make known among the nations what he has done. Make known among the nations what God has done. Testify of the goodness of the Lord. The psalmist says, when you have delivered me, I shall testify of the goodness of the Lord in the congregation of the saints. Sometimes we are so ungrateful that we can't give God thanks. We can't give God thanks. But we need to have a heart of gratitude. Psalm 50 verse 14 says, sacrifice thank offerings to God. Sacrifice thank offerings to God. That is that offering that I tell you about. When you want to make a real sacrifice, you see, sacrifice hurts. Amen?
Amen.
Sacrifice is painful. Sacrifice is not what you are comfortable with giving.
Amen.
Sacrifice is painful. Sacrifice is when you understand that although you have so many bills and so many cares, that the money you have can hardly, even when you spend all of it, it doesn't solve your problem. So what do you do with it? You take it and you bring it to God. When Elijah turned up to the widow who was about to die, who had her last meal, and when the man of God looked at her and he says, what do you have to eat? She says, I only have a little meal. She said, I don't even have wood for the fire. All I have is few sticks to cook it with. Elijah said, okay, go make your last meal. But one thing I'm asking you, give me the first dumpling. If pastor ever asked that of you, look at him as he's crazy. You must be crazy. You must be crazy. There he goes again. Elijah says, make me the first meal. That is a sacrifice. That is a sacrifice. And she must have said in her heart, well, I don't have nothing to lose. Tomorrow I'm going to die. I don't have nothing to lose. If this is not the man of God, if what he's saying doesn't work, I have nothing to lose. But right now, I'm going to extend my faith to God, to the God of Elijah.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to make him a meal. I'm going to make him a meal. I'm going to make him a meal. And she got up and she obeyed the man of God. And the Bible says that she had so much meal and so much oil. She was the richest person in town on the following day. She was meeting the needs of people everywhere. They wanted her to run for president. That's not in scripture. But I'm telling you today, God can do that for you.
Amen.
If you have a grateful heart. The psalmist says, sacrifice a thank offering to God and fulfill your vows to the Most High. Those promises you made God when you said, if you get that job, if you get that job, if you get that visa, those promises you made to God, the psalmist says you are to keep them and you are to make a thank offering.
Amen.
A sacrifice, a sacrificial one, not a convenient one. You see, if you give a month of your income to God in your envelope, that's a sacrifice. If you give a year of your income, that's a sacrifice. But when you come and some of us know the bills, you know, we rub our fingers on them in the pocket and in the pocketbook, we dig deep down in there, we feel, we'll come up
giving God what is convenient for us. God says, you must give till it hurts. A sacrificial giving. Psalm 107 verse 22 says, let them sacrifice thank offerings and tell of his works with songs of joy. That is cheerful giving. For the Lord loveth a cheerful giver.
You talk about offering, I hear somebody in the congregation murmuring. I think I must get the money for it. And they're complaining in the congregation. It can sweet me when I talk about money from the pulpit and I see people like ants biting them. I'm telling you, I see people like ants biting them. And they're shoving things here and they're shoving things there. Sweet me. I go home and I say, my God, what was wrong with that sister? What was wrong? Shuffling up everything and moving. Remember I said I see it, you know? But God wants you to give thanks in the tough times. Not only in the good times, not only when the turkey's on the table, but you give thanks in the tough times. Not only when you can eat a steak, but you give thanks when all you can afford, well now codfish is more expensive than steak. Amen. But you have nothing to put on the table. Give thanks. Give thanks. I often tell you about people I used to know. They used to put on their pots with the water. They put on their pots with the water. I know this preacher's wife. She would put on the pot with the water. Nothing to put in the water. Amen. And she would stand over that wood fire with the pot, with the water, and pray to God for a provision. Hallelujah. And before she finished praying, somebody come and call out her name. They bring a piece of yam. They bring something for her to cook in the water. That's what I'm talking about this morning.
Amen.
That's faith in God. And they don't pout up on God and say, God, how come the person down the street yam beer so well? How come the person on the street have a bigger harvest than me? Yeah. They're thanking God for the harvest of the person down the street. Yeah. Because that person down the street won't bless them. Yeah. They don't covet them. The song says, sowing in the morning, sowing in the evening. Psalm 126 says, and they that sow in tears shall reap with joy, bringing their sheaves behind them. Sowing is going to cost you, but the reward is great. I'm not telling you about a lottery system. I'm telling you about God, the great provider. I told you about a woman who had a parrot who always complained about everything. And it was Thanksgiving Eve, and she was preparing the Thanksgiving meal, and the parrot complained about everything as she worked. Finally, she had heard enough. And she took him out of his cage, opened the refrigerator to put him in there to punish him. You'll stay in the refrigerator till you cool off. And get control of your tongue. She said as she put him and closed the door, the parrot was stunned, shivering. He caught a glimpse of the Thanksgiving turkey. Skinned. The legs up. Pointing upward out of the pan. Parrot said to the turkey, "Good heavens, man, what did you say?" He saw somebody worse off than him. He said, "Good heavens, man, what did you say? I mean, I only got put in the refrigerator. But you're cooked." When you give thanks in tough times, Thanksgiving does three things. I'm going to go through them quickly for you. Number one, Thanksgiving cultivates character. Thanksgiving cultivates character. Thanksgiving cultivates the mental and moral qualities that is distinctive to any individual. Thanksgiving cultivates character. Notice that Paul says, the cultivation of gratitude is the will of God. The cultivation of gratitude is the will of God for you. Cicero, the Roman poet, observed, "Thanksgiving is not only the greatest of all virtues, it is the parent of all virtues." In gratitude, my mother used to say, is worse than witchcraft. An ungrateful person is a terrible person. You must be thankful for the simplest of things. You see, it might not mean anything to you, but it meant a lot to the person who gave. And it doesn't matter what they have, because the more you have, is the harder it is to let go of the least. Amen? The more you have, is the harder it is to let go of the least. All right. I give you $1 million. You walk in here today and you get $1 million. Your tithe is $100,000. Huh? Your tithe is $100,000. You just got $1 million. God just blessed you with $1 million. Your tithe is $100,000. You know how many of you would need me in church again? This man won the lottery in Florida. $190 million. When he got the money after taxes, was much less than that. But he made out a check to his church for $19 million. The reporter asked him, how could you draw such a big check to give to your church? He said, God gave me this money. And this is only 10% of the growth. He gave those $19 million to the church. He bought the lotto ticket again. And he won $180 million. And he drew another check for $18 million. And gave it to his church. I'm not going to ask you. But were you trustworthy with what God gave you this week? Did you bring in his 10% with thanksgiving? Parents recognize this principle when raising children. One of the first virtues we try to instill in them is the virtue of thanksgiving. When the child receives something, you ask the child, what did you say? The child knows that you meant that he or she should say thank you. Before that child goes to bed at night, you teach that child to pray and thank God for a good day, for all the meals. Without that teaching, they grow up to be selfish, narcissistic, manipulative, complaining, and thinking that the world owes them something. They grow up ungrateful. Not knowing how to say thanks. This morning I challenge you to focus on your haves and not your have-nots. Focus on what you have and not on what you do not have. The hymn says, count your blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord has done. Count your blessings. Name them one by one. And it will surprise you what the Lord has done. The psalmist says in Psalm 103, verse 2, forget not all God's benefits. Do not forget God's benefits. Secondly, thanksgiving increases your joy. Thanksgiving increases your joy. Notice the connection here between verses 16 and 18. Rejoicing and thanksgiving. Rejoicing and thanksgiving. The Greek word for rejoicing, it's chariot. It means to be joyful, to express joy. To express joy. You know, when you sing this chorus here about being glad, I'm looking at your faces and you don't look so glad. You don't look so glad. I'm saying, boy, if they're glad with their faces like that, Lord, please never let me make the, never make me see them sad. For this is their glad face. I can't imagine what the sad face
looks like. So please, Lord, spare me. The word thanksgiving is ephoris in the Greek. The joy that comes brings thanksgiving. If you don't give thanks, what will you give? Anger, resentment, doubt, malice, complaint. The secret of abounding joy is the gratitude attitude. I am grateful. There are some people I like to talk to on the phone. I am grateful. You want to hear rejoicing? Get Sister Rima's number after church. Call her in the morning. She's at work. She's working hard. But let me tell you something. If you don't want an upliftment for the day and you want to have a pity party, don't call her. Sit down, be sorry for yourself. But if you want a rejoicing heart, call her. Because she's going to tell you all the reasons she's happy this morning. The work is hard, the pay is little, but she praises God. She praises God. Some people you call them, it's just a whole conversation and you're wondering, when are they going to finish? I called somebody one time and they were alone on the phone. Because I put the phone down. I just couldn't take no more. And then when I heard the voice came down, I picked up the phone and I said, all right, let's pray now and thank God. Let's thank God. Because all you can hear 100 times, complaining, complaining, complaining. When you can't change the wind, it is said, adjust the sails. When you cannot change the wind, adjust the sails. There are some things you just can't do anything about. Here's a compilation of sayings by Thomas Nelson, the publisher. Be on the lookout for mercies. The more we look for them, the more of them we will see. Blessings brighten when we count them. Out of the determination of the heart, the eyes see. If you want to be gloomy, there's gloom enough to keep you glum. If you want to be happy, there's gleam enough to keep you glad. Better to lose count while naming your blessings than to lose your blessings by counting your trouble. Better to lose count while naming your blessings than to lose your blessings by counting your troubles. Thirdly and lastly, thanksgiving conquers your problems. That does not mean that all your problems go away when you give thanks. But your problems stop being such a problem when you start to give thanks. They don't go away, but they stop being such a problem when you give thanks. Paul complained about his infirmities to God. And he went to God 3 times. God, why can't you take it away from me? The third time he went to God, God says, it's not such a big deal, Paul. My grace is sufficient for you. God's grace is sufficient for you in the bad times. It's good to experience God's grace. My wife and I were watching a movie last night, and this lady inherited $100 million. $100 million. She gave away every dime of the money. And when she gave away the last penny, she said, I am free at last. I am free at last. She wrote more checks than she could think of, giving away every last dime of the $100 million. She gave to the Red Cross. She gave to everybody. She just gave away the money. And when she gave away the last penny, she wrote in her journal, I am free at last.
You think you have trouble? I am free at last. You live from the inside out. What goes on around you no longer controls the condition of the world inside you. Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Praise God. When you have Jesus inside of you, the things around you become minute because there is a greater force, a greater joy, a greater peace than any material thing could bring you going on the inside of you. Therefore, you start to sing. That old chorus says, it's bubbling. It's bubbling. It's bubbling in my soul. I'm singing. I'm shouting since Jesus made me whole. Folks can't understand it, but I cannot keep it quiet. It's bubbling, bubbling, bubbling. It's bubbling in my soul. It's a greater thing happening inside of me than what's happening in the world around me. And when everybody thinks that the world is crashing, I am singing. It's bubbling. E. Stanley Jones said, bitterness comes to all, sours some, sweetens others. Bitterness comes to all, sours some, but sweeten others. I shall use it to sweeten my spirit. When bitterness comes, use it to sweeten your spirit. You know, if you've had something bitter, and you put something else that is not so sweet in your mouth, that thing that comes in after the bitterness has a wonderful taste. Has a wonderful Do not let what you're going through make you
sour.
Amen. Amen.
Let it sweeten your life.
Amen.
Let it sweeten your life. Some of you will have to go through it. Face the facts.
Yes.
Face the facts.
Yes.
Face the facts. You're going to have to go through it. Yes. Why? Because God can't trust you with much. You'll forget it. The richest man in the world says, do not give me riches, lest I forget you.
Yes.
Please don't give me extreme poverty, because that will make me steal. You can make all the promises you want to make now if you win the lottery. Oh yeah. Make all the promises you want to make. All the relatives you're going to take care of. And everybody you're going to fix up, on how much you're going to give to the church. As a matter of fact, you're going to build that church. You're not only going to give, I mean, you're going to build that church. You're going to build a cathedral for global. Then I start asking, what happened to brother so-and-so? What happened to sister so-and-so? Oh, they won the lottery. You can't control the problems that come into your life. All the events that could be summed up in the phrase, in everything, give thanks. You can't control the problems that come into your life, but you can control how you respond to them. You can control how you respond to them. The Bible gives you this command, in everything, give thanks. That must be your response. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In everything, give thanks. Thanksgiving delivers us from victim mentality. Thanksgiving delivers us from victim mentality and gives us a victor's mentality. For I am more than conqueror, hallelujah, through Christ Jesus. I am more than conqueror through Christ Jesus, who strengthens me. I have strength for this. This too shall pass. I am going to give thanks till it is gone.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I am not a victim. I am a victor. It is said that nothing can help the person with the wrong mental attitude, and nothing can stop a person with a right mental attitude.
Amen.
Nothing can help the person with the wrong mental attitude. And nothing can stop a person who has the right mental attitude.
Yes.
And the right mental attitude to overcome your obstacles in your battles today is thanksgiving.
Amen.
Rejoice evermore. Pray without ceasing. In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. God bless you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You have the right attitude now in the tough times, in the dark times, in the valley. It may seem homeless, hopeless, but we got to give God the praise anyway. Amen. Hallelujah. invitational hymn in your hymnals, number 654. Change my heart, O God. 654.
Ask God to take the heart of complaining, take the heart of anxiety from you, because this is the holiday season. Yeah, I tell you, I never used to do well in holidays like this. Oh no, I'm telling you. I preached the other day and my wife said, you preach to yourself all day? I said, yeah, because I never handled holiday well. I was Mr. Grinch. Always miserable. Anxiety. Why we have to go over there for this? Why we have to... Just couldn't have the right attitude. Some things you got to pray about in life.
Amen.
Yeah.
But God can give you a new heart. Change my heart, O God. Make it ever true. Change my heart, O God. May I be like you. Give me a heart of thanksgiving. As we sing that song, you know what you've been going through. You know how you've neglected to give God thanks in your situation. The altar is open.
Yes.
Please leave your seat. Come to the altar. Bring your sacrifice of praise and come with thanksgiving and ask God to give you a heart with the right attitude. Change my heart too. If we're willing to yield to you today,
yes.
If we're willing to give thanks to you today for what we are,
yes.
Where we are, and who we are, you can make us God.
Hallelujah.
into what you want us to be. Thank you for everyone here, from the youngest to the greatest.
Thank you.
You know the desires of every heart. And I ask you, God, where there is a heart of ingratitude, that you would change that heart and give that person a right attitude.
Praise
you. Bless us as we go through these seasons. Cause your face to shine upon us.
Yes.
God, we ask you in the name of Jesus,
the name of
to do a great work within us.
Hallelujah.
So that we will praise you. And those on the outside will want some of what we've done. We say thanks now as we leave our lives, our souls, our spirits, our minds in your care. Say thanks in Jesus' name. Everybody say amen. Remember that on Thursday morning, Thanksgiving Day, our Thanksgiving service will start at 10. A.M. sharp. It will not be a long service because we want you to go home and enjoy your Thanksgiving meal. But Thanksgiving is not about overeating. Thanksgiving is about giving thanks. So we want you to come on Thursday morning at 10 a.m. Let us give thanks. Amen?
Amen.
786 is our closing hymn. Count your blessings.
Count your blessings. And what you want to say, let's go.
bless you and keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you. And the Lord give you peace, both now, henceforth, and forevermore. God bless you. Take Jesus with you. Have a peaceful Sunday. Amen. Thank you, darling. Thank you.